questions.
I was happy with our guys' effort tonight. For like, we battled and competed for 40 minutes. But they're a very good basketball team. You know, in every position, they're very, very good. So we came out, I thought we had a great start. And much of the time we end up having a scoring drought. And we saw that in the middle of the first half. And a lot of it was our own fault. Guys taking, Marcus takes a jump shot, Don takes an ill-advised shot. We could have gotten better shots, and that led to them going up by 10 at half.
I was gonna ask you about the offense. If I did the math right, you guys were scoring close to 75 the first 13 games and down to about 55 the last three. Is it taking bad shots, or there a couple
part of
things?
Part of it is, you know, guys forcing the issue, but then part of it is also using more clock to get a good shot, not coming down, you know, in the non-conference, you know, teams don't know you as well. They haven't seen you year in, year out, you know, the personnel as well. There's not as much film out on you. And so now you come into a situation in conference where everybody knows what everybody wants to run. And so in order to get a good shot, you gotta work a little bit harder. You gotta execute more. You gotta do a better job setting the screen. You gotta come off the screen a little bit harder. And so, you know, I didn't want it to be an up and down game against these guys, because we're not gonna win that game. We didn't obviously win that anyway, but we're definitely not gonna win that game with them. So you come down and you run more clock to just shrink the game a little bit and you know, shorten the game a little bit. So that's part of it. But yeah, we had a couple guys take some shots at crucial parts of the first half when they made a run that you know, I prefer them not take.
Justice has been taking a lot more shot attempts in the last three or four games. Is that something you and him have talked about, or is that something you kind of just...
No, today was more of a focus on him getting looks, because we felt like that was our only real mismatch. You know, having DeAndre Ayton try to guard Justice Sweet off the bounce, we felt like we could take advantage of that. And it worked out from time to time, but, you know, then he got to the line 14 times, didn't capitalize as much as we wanted, 7 for 14 from the free throw line. But we knew that was the one area where we would have an advantage, with them having 2 7-footers trying to stay in front of a guy like Justice. And so it was more of a focus to get him looks today.
Marcus Lee was able to stay out of foul trouble today with only 4 points, 2 rebounds. Would you like to see him be more aggressive on offense?
He actually didn't stay out of foul trouble. He picked up his second with 8 minutes to go in the first half. I would like to see him just be more hungry down there in the paint. You know, he's a talented young man, and you know, he's a senior. He's a, you know, and fifth-year senior, and he's been in big games time and time again in his career, and so. I just like to see him be more more aggressive down there. So, yeah, it would be nice. He got into foul trouble. We were able to put him in the second half. But, sometimes with him, interesting enough, is he gets into foul trouble. He starts off well. Like against Washington State, he goes 3 for 4. Then he gets into foul trouble, and then he sits, and then he has to sit at half, and then he comes back, and he's not the same. And so I worry about that with him when he picks up fouls early.
Coach, you continue to have problems defending the three, but today you've got to also defend an NBA lottery pick in the middle. How do you try to balance your defense?
You've got to have to pick your poison at that point. Do you want those guys hurting you, Ristic and Ayton? Do you want them hurting you in the paint, getting your guys in foul trouble? Or do you play the zone and kind of keep it tight and, you know, dare them to miss the long three? They made the long three tonight. Guys that don't normally shoot the ball, you know, Parker Cartwright goes, you know, he goes 4 for 6 from 3, and he's not even a high volume shooter like that, you know. But he, you know, he saw opportunities and he knocked them down. And that's part of, you know, playing against a veteran player.
You were talking about how there's much more scouting in the conference. Mm-hmm. Do you think people are looking at what you do defensively and find holes in that zone to shoot the perimeter shot?
I think they're seeing what other people are shooting against us, and they come in with a little bit more confidence, thinking that they can make shots. Not that they're finding holes, it just, you know, their coaches are saying you probably can get good looks. And, you know, we had to make the adjustment at half. Our wings were doing a poor job on the swing, getting out to their wing shooters and waiting for the bump. And so we made the adjustment at halftime, did a better job in the second half. At that point, you know, now you let a guy see himself hit a couple shots, and so it's tough.
I take it your opinion on Ayton didn't change?
No, absolutely not. He's a talented young man. And he plays hard, and he has a really good demeanor. You know, even when things don't seem like they're going well, he handles himself the right way. And so
he was 9 for 11. It went pretty well for him most of the night.
He's really good. Really good.
You guys forced 11 turnovers in the first half for 12 points off those turnovers. Was there anything specific you guys were doing to kind of force those turnovers early?
Well, we knew that Parker Jackson Cartwright was their main, he's the main ball handler for them. And so when he goes out of the game, we feel like, okay, even with Trier, as talented as he is, he's not accustomed to being in that role, having to run the team. And so we knew that when they went to their bench and brought in some of the other guards, that we could heat them up a little bit. And so we took advantage.
Twice in the past 3 games where you guys have forced 20 turnovers. Do you see some things you like there that you're getting out of the
Yeah, I do. I do. I think it, you know, more than anything, it forces our guys to be aggressive. Just being in the press gives us a little bit more energy defensively. I like what it provides for us. We have to do a better job. So today, I think, you know, they did a good job of, when they did beat it, they did a good job of attacking on the baseline with their bigs, and so we got to have better rim protection.
Any other questions for Coach?
Coach, what did you think of your press today, and then also on the other side, your guards and the ball handling, ball security?
I thought the press was good today, indicative of 21 turnovers and 14 steals for us. Our guards had to do a better job of being able to handle when they blitz out on us, when they double team the ball screens, being able to handle that pressure and being able to be tough with the ball and make the right decision. So that's something that we have to continue to work on.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
Thanks, Coach.